output. Most often, output is something called a BAM file, but really the underlying file is called the SAM. Remember, it's some item, just alignment output format. And so the very beginning of the file has a number of these things that are headers. You can see these things in the header. There's some sorting order, the format version, you know, the reference name. And this is the NCBI 37 is kind of a one version of this human genome assembly. And now you might be dealing with HG38, which is NCBI 38. It's kind of the newest genome assembly. And you can say this, you know, whether it's Illumina or Solid, is a different type of platform. What program do you use to do the sorting? This is BWA, one of the aligners, and the version of the program. Okay? And then you can add some lines of common text. So in general, these are the headers, and all of these are kind of ignored when the downstream analysis is done. The actual mapping file looks like this. Remember, the original FASTQ is four lines per actual sequence, right? The mapped files are in this SAM format. Sorry, there's a return here. This is actually a whole sequence ID. So from here all the way to here is a sequence ID. And 16 and 4 and 16, these are the mapping result. If it's 0, it's mapped to the plus strand of the genome. This DNA is double-stranded. If it's 0, it means it's mapped to the plus strand. If it's 16, it just happens to map to the reverse strand. So both 0 and 16 are no problem. 4 means unmapped. You do not know where this thing is coming from. Very often, when you do genome assembly, it's not uncommon for 20% or even 30% to be unmappable. You can imagine there's all sorts of other things floating in the air as you're preparing things. You know, maybe some bacteria, things are kind of mixed in the final DNA. That's kind of the nice thing. The nice thing about high throughput sequencing, even things you can't grow the culture, right? You can just scoop, you know, dirt and ocean or whatever, you poo-poo, you know, get the DNA, you can still sequence them. And so whatever you think you're sequencing a human tumor, but there are other junk that's there. And then after that is, you know, map to chromosome, some location, and there's some scores. This one here, the 38 match, this is a sequence of 38 nucleotide, and all of them match. These two are pretty easy. So this is the actual sequence. This is the quality score. So you can see the SAM file really has all the information. It's a smaller file, but also capture more information than the FASTQ. XA is mapper specific. But this part, MP, is the actual mismatch information. For example, this one is saying, initially we have some matches. So we have three matches in the beginning. TA, C. And then the next one, C is the reference, but then the actual sequence. Let's see. These are the first three. And this one, the reference sequence is C, but our sequence is A. And then there will be 30 nucleotide that is the reference sequence. And then the next phase, this should be the reference sequence is T. It's 1, 2, 3. But then this sequence is G. And then the remaining three will match. Okay? So for something like this, you know, MPZ38, it will mean everything matches. But in this one, you can see how it's mapped to the reference genome. There are two mismatches in here. Okay? And also this is just a total number of mismatches too. And so this file actually really captures both the sequence quality, where it matches the genome. This is the file that you will likely need to use for a lot of your other, you know, sequencing applications. You can also convert this into a binary format. It's just, you know, like a binary file is smaller. If you like uncompress it, it would just be the same format. Okay. Another type of format is called a web file. In the early days, people sometimes also use web files to represent weeds, but nowadays it's mostly used for representing a region rather than a, because right now there's like too many lines or so it's actually a simpler format. You have a reference name, so it basically says you have a read that's mapped to chromosome 1 at this starting and 11th location. Well, assuming this is the, it could represent a read or could represent a region. So say, okay, this region is from chromosome 1, position 1000 to 1500. You can give it whatever name, and it has some score, and this is actually on the class rank of that region. Okay. In early days, people also use it to map to reads, but now it's mostly a particular interval. Yeah, there's some specification. There's also something called a big bed. It's kind of index file, so you can. It's similar to the BAM file versus SAM file. It's kind of more compressed, and you can. There are genome browsers that can access these files and do the search very quickly. Once you have the BAM file and the BED file already mapped to the genome, you can display them on genome browsers. This is the UC Santa Cruz genome browser. This run on a website. You upload your file there, it will display the genome. You can also run it on something called IGV, Integrated Genomic Viewer, which is kind of a local JavaScript, a Java program. You also upload your BAM files, your BED files, it will display the genome browser. And then there are some things that are, for example, gene annotation. These are already in the genome browser that comes with the program loaded. But this would be whatever you loaded on your track. Say we're looking at chromosome 19 between this interval. And these are some reads that landed there. You can also specify colors, say plus or minus strand. You can whatever specify the color. But BAM file will be similar, except that these might be a little wider. You can see it is a stretch. There's another stretch, okay? And so from the mapping, you can already see how the read landed along here. And you might be able to see that this is an RNA-seq read, because this is an annotated gene with no transcript with, these are the exons on this gene. And you can see the reads mostly land on these exons, right? And so that gives you some idea how your reads are distributed. You can look at the raw data in some kind of raw format, in this BAM format. Okay, questions? Okay, can we restart the...